10 little sailor boys. Charming.
It'll never work, I tell you. We should never have agreed. A house party only a week after we arrive? And no other help?
Ethel, calm yourself.
You promised me. Never again, you said.
How was I to know? Oh, Mr. Narricott. Ethel will be preparing you a meal in here once the guests are served.
I copied the contents into my notebook. I copied the contents into my notebook.
Would you just look at all these silk sheets? All embroidered GS. I'll bet that was that actress who used to live here. I've dropped them on this filthy floor.
Can I give you a hand, Mrs. Rogers?
Thank you, Mr. Narricott. You seem like a good sort. I'm sorry for your boat.
Tightly locked.
My wife is indisposed, not receiving visitors today.
Your wife, sir?
What?
Your wife?
My wife, yes. Leslie. I'm sorry, my boy. I was wool gathering miles away. My apologies. Must dress for dinner now. Send my orderly to me, if you will. No, that's not right. What was I thinking? I must get ready for dinner now.
Yes? Oh, Mr. Narricott, I had a question for you. Have you heard anything in Sticklehaven about this house being set up as a guest house?
No, Miss Brent.
No, Mrs. Rogers hasn't either. And who are the Owens?
I haven't met them yet.
Would it surprise you to learn neither have Mr. and Mrs. Rogers? It's odd, very odd. If you'll excuse me, Mr. Narricott, I must make dinner preparations. Mr. Narricott, I thought that you'd left us.
Someone scuttled my boat.
Oh, but that's dreadful. Surely the harbour master will send another boat when you're missed.
Not in this storm, I'm afraid. And even then, it won't be reported.
Why ever not?
My brother. He knew I might not be immediately back.
I'm terribly sorry for your trouble. The Owens should be arriving shortly. I'm sure you can get a ride back in that boat. If you'll excuse me, I must get ready for dinner.
Narricott? I thought you'd be long gone by now. That storm's getting pretty fierce.
Somebody scuttled my boat.
I saw Blore watching you like a hawk eyes its dinner. Could it have been him?
Possibly.
Any idea why?
I'd rather not say.
Suit yourself. I'd better get ready for dinner.
this clock has stopped. I copied the contents into my notebook.
Once a bent copper, always a bent copper. Right, Fred?
You're talking through your hat. You were the Purcell gang's inside man on the force, not my brother.
Your brother? Don't try to kid me, Fred. There's still a handsome reward out for you.
Fred is my brother. I'm Patrick Fane.
No reason for me to believe you that I can see. There's still a big reward out for Fred Fane.
You scuttled my boat to trap me here.
You recognized me, too. I saw it in your eyes.
Only because Davis showed Fred the passenger list yesterday. I came in my brother's place. We didn't think you might mistake me for him. Fred is 8 years older than me. Look closely, Blore.
You do look young. I noticed that. Thought it must be the sea air.
You were taking the Purcells' bribes for years. After the Landor case, people began to ask questions. The Purcells needed what the Yank detective novels call a fall guy. My brother was framed. You were in the clear.
Your whole story sounds like a detective novel.
I've never stopped trying to clear Fred's name and put you in Dartmoor Prison where you belong. Thanks to your greed, I may now have that chance.
Maybe you're Patrick, maybe you're Fred. I don't know, and I don't much care. You're either a criminal, or you've been harboring one all these years. I wonder what my fellow guests will think of that. Go on, Mr. Narracott. Hop it. I need to prepare for dinner.
Nothing out of order in here. I'd best not take anything, though. I'm sure he would notice.
I copied the contents into my notebook. It's locked fast.
You're shot, Judge.
Yes. You haven't left me much, I confess.
I knew judges listened to confessions. I never knew they made them as well.
Oh, some judges may have cause. Some doctors as well, I expect.
That sounds like the dinner bell.
Mr. Narracott, unfortunately, we are not prepared for your presence at dinner. I would be most happy to deliver you a sandwich later this evening, if that will do.
That will be fine, Rogers. Thank you.
Excellent. Now, if you will excuse me, I must get to serving.
By all means. I can hear them all in the dining room chattering. I can't quite make out what they're saying. This might be a good time to explore the house more thoroughly.